Hello, it's Fusion Fan here, and here we are with a new house build. This is a very modern house. It's definitely not something that I'm used to building. And it's definitely not my style of house, but it kind of works. It's like, it's almost like two boxes on top of each other. You will see what I mean by that in a second when it is all. See, now we can see the two boxes. It's gonna be very white and just will look very modern. Empty, kind of. It kind of looks a bit empty. It's very boxy. But it's here and we are doing a voiceover for it as we speak. It's a Sunday here. It's raining. Nice weather. Very stormy autumn weather. I've built this house a while ago, and it was waiting for me to get to this point to record this voiceover and post this build. And here you can see me trying to figure out some kind of floor plan that makes sense but also doesn't use the space we have in a strange way, if that makes any sense. So I kind of wanted to create two rooms, but then I would like two equal size rooms, and that was not really gonna happen. It's been a while since I've recorded a voiceover on a Sunday, but it just seems like the right time to do this. So we're doing it. And, if I could just speak, speaking would be so easy. If I could just speak, not asking for much here. But, we are doing this bit of the roof. And it looks kind of nice that I did two different heights of these fences. So that at least the house gets an interesting shape. I believe an interesting shape is what you want. Because you could just build a box. Nobody just wants a box. Using this very vibrant green lime color. It's definitely not my taste, but it does work. So we're trying to incorporate that, and then we're using this wooden paneling as a feature wall. And this screen is almost hurting my eyes. And then it seems fitting to put down a table that has the same color as this wooden paneling, and we're putting down some stools and a chair and then a lamp above the table, and I think now we'll work, and then probably we'll continue to the kitchen. Different type of rug. Although I wouldn't want to live in a house like this, it was quite easy to build, which is also handy. Because it often is handy to have a house that's easy to build. But it also gets easier if you build more. You will find out that building isn't as hard as it used to be. You figure out where to place stuff, what works best. You also learn what you have available in your game, which is also very useful. And of course, incorporating some of this ugly green. And I'm not a big fan of green as it is, but this is very vibrant, and that would also not be something that I would be into. If it was a minty green, it would be fine. But this is definitely not a minty green. Not even close. And of course, you need to have a plant and then some art on the walls. And a bookcase. So I already told you this is a house I've built a while back. I think the house before this one is something that I've built in the same world. I am not really a legacy player, but this happened to be a house for the one of the girls that the family that I was playing with had. And the previous house is also from one of those girls, those daughters. And then eventually these kids move on and they spread their wings or something like that. And that just happened to be that. And I needed houses. And I decided to film it. But that's probably also why it was easier to build a house, just because I had played with this family for a while, and I was there for these girls to grow up. I think this one is in a relationship with the guy that used to deliver the newspaper. Yes. That's that's where you find your man, apparently. The one that delivers the newspaper. I don't have a newspaper, so I won't find my man that way. And I think her favorite color is this green color. And his favorite color is the brownish color upstairs in the bedroom. And you probably saw what I had the bed stashed in the family inventory. That's the same bed that they had in the house where she grew up. And it might seem a bit strange, but we have two full bathrooms. One is an ensuite upstairs, and the other bathroom is downstairs. That's also a full bathroom. At this moment, this family that lives here doesn't have a kid. But I think the last time I played, she was pregnant. So there might be a kid if I ever open up this save file again. And of course we stash in a plant, because a plant's always useful. If you ever have room in your house, just chuck in a plant. Don't ask me how you take care of plants, because that I don't know, but I do know that you need to chuck a plant in every room. That's exactly what I've done. Oh, apart from my bathrooms, I have downstairs just a toilet and a sink, and then upstairs I have a bath and shower combo. My washing machine is there and another sink. There are no plants in those rooms, but especially the upstairs bathroom is always open, the door, so I think that probably is fine. Just looking at this build, this screen is getting more annoying to me than it was when I started. But we have built this build in, if I look at the timeline, in two times. The first one looks to be about an hour. I usually build for 1 hour at a time. That's also as long as the podcast is that I listen to, which makes sense that I built that long then. At least to me it makes sense. And we're jumping into the second time I was building. Here it comes. We're just finishing off this house. We were left here outside with some of this hideous green on this chair, because hideous green is just what you need apparently. And then we chuck in some candles or nothing. I would say I chuck in something, because it would be nice to have some light outside. I like these lanterns. These lanterns look really nice. And I like the fact that there is a thing here next to the door where there is a mirror and some shelves where you could stash stuff and drop your keys. Not quite sure what we're putting on these shelves, but we are definitely trying to fill up some space right here. And really give it a little bit less of a very modern house, but more of a home, family home feel. And we chuck in a fountain piece and some landscaping, of course, because that's precious. That really ties it in if you use some landscaping around the place. and an easel. You can definitely tell that's the end of the afternoon. Because I am getting tired. And now we are doing this bedroom. Perhaps one of the kids, if there is a kid. I don't think they had kids already. If you had this room as a kid, you probably would like work in there because it's a bit tiled, and tiles are not nice to play on. So it definitely is nice that this house has some rugs on the floor. On the wall, I think that would be the end of this house build, at least for me. Of course, I have put in the screenshots at the end of the video, but if you enjoyed watching, thumbs this video up, subscribe to my channel so you see the next video when it's out. My name is Vriesenfan, and I hope you have a lovely day. Goodbye.